Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another Pokemon Sleep video. Today, we are talking specifically about dish strength. Have you ever noticed that the dish strength does some weird numbers along the way and you're not really quite sure how the numbers are calculated? And you're not quite sure whether you should be adding extra ingredients, how much bonus you actually get from those extra ingredients, and so on. So I'm going to explain to you how the dish strength is calculated. And for those of you who are maths inclined, I'm going to give you a formula for that as well. Now, before I explain to you how dish strength is calculated, there's two things you gotta know at baseline. One is that every ingredient has a specific strength associated with it. So for example, tasty mushroom, which is by the way, a pretty rare ingredient, has 167 base strength. So every one of these you add is supposed to give you 167. But it's not going to be exactly 167. I'll explain to you why in a moment. Other less rare ingredients, such as bean sausage, 103. And we've got fancy apples, which is probably the most common ingredient because Pikachu is one of our starter Pokemon, drops a lot of apples, 90 base strength. And the other thing you got to know is that if you cook a specific dish, and I'm going to refer to these charts originally made by Chisao, one of our Discord members. If you follow a recipe, so let's say bulk bean curry, for example, and if you actually add the total strength of having the base strength of each ingredient into this dish, you will find that the total strength should be 2798 for this dish here. So 12 times the strength for green grass soybean, which is 100. So 12 times 100 plus 6 times the bean sausage, etc., etc., you get 2798. But actually, the game will give you a little bit of a bonus for cooking a recipe. So that's why over here for this dish, so let's take bulk up bean curry as the example, you'll find that at level 0, so the first time you cook it, level 0, it will have an additional about 500 more base strength. Now that's just a bonus, that's not related to any multipliers. So you'll need to refer to this chart if you want to know what the base strength, so level 0 strength, is of a certain dish. This chart is available on our Discord and it's under Quick Guides. It's one of the more readily accessible channels in our Discord. Just scroll up a little bit and you'll find the charts there. Now, knowing this strength isn't as important as the numbers that the game gives you when you actually look at the dishes menu. So for example, let's take Dazzling Apple Cheese Salad here. It's at 3300 strength, but for you, it might be a bit different. So why does it look different to begin with? And that's because I've leveled up my Dazzling Apple Cheese Salad. So to get to this number over here, how the game works is, it will take the base strength of the Dazzling Apple Cheese Salad, which is 2578, and multiply that, the base strength, by the level bonus, which is 28% for this level 16 dish. And 2578 times 1.28 is 3300, which is the dish strength that the menu showed us earlier. So back over here, 3300. So the earlier numbers are already done for you. So the numbers for the level bonus are already done for you. You don't actually need to calculate that yourself. But what about from this point on to get to the final strength that Snorlax gets from the dish? Now I've got this video of cooking pre-recorded and I'm just taking some screenshots from that recording to show you what I've done. So this dish requires 23 ingredients and I'm going to max out that pot by adding 10 more extra ingredients, and there will be 7 sausages, 2 milk and 1 honey. So 7 sausages, 2 milk and 1 honey on top of what's needed for this dish. So you can see this is 7 sausages, 2 more milk and then the 1 honey. And there we go, getting added to the pot. And an interesting thing to note here is if you've ever noticed, what these numbers are the base strength of the ingredient. Remember the chart I showed you earlier? So sausages will display 103, Milk will display 98 and honey will display 101, which is what we get in that screenshot back over here. So the game actually tells you it's adding this amount of strength from your extra ingredients. Now what this means is the level bonus doesn't actually apply to any extra ingredients that you add. The level bonus will only apply to the dish itself, but there is still a problem. Somehow, I ended up with an even bigger strength than what I expected. And here I'm just showing you that I added 7 sausages, and sausages have each 103 strength. I added 2 milk and 1 honey. Milk has 98 strength, and honey has 101 strength. And the total is supposed to be 1,018 in extra strength. So how did we go from 3,300 plus 1018, which is 4,318. How do we go from this to this? And that's because there's one more factor at play here, and it is the area bonus. So area bonus applies extra strength to berries fed to Snorlax, but also dishes. Now my area bonus is 1.25 times, So 25%, so this is what we're going to do, times 1.25. And this number, 5397, is indeed exactly the strength that the dish is when it's fed to Snorlax. So I'm going to refer you to the formula now over here in terms of how dish strength is calculated. So to get the display dish strength, the menu dish strength, the what the game tells you is the base strength times the level bonus. And for the base strength, you will have to refer to the chart from Giselle. But to calculate the final strength, which is what you really want to know over here, you simply use the displayed dish strength. So in my case, it was the 3,300, which has already accounted for the level bonus. Then you add the extra ingredient strength in. So the sausages and the milk that I added later on, you add that in. You times the entire thing by the area bonus, and that is how you get the final dish strength. So if you understood this formula, you'll also understand that extra ingredients added do not benefit from level bonus, but they do benefit from area bonus, which is really interesting. So let's say on Sunday, you weren't going to cook too much anyway because you weren't going to make the next tier, the next Snorlax tier for more sleep styles, etc. And you hang on to those ingredients for the next week when the area bonus has gone up by 5%. Your ingredients are actually worth more in the next week than the week before. Hopefully that makes sense. If it didn't make sense, just watch the video again or ask me on my Discord channel. And one more point, just for completeness sake, if you're wondering how much level bonus goes up every time you level up the dish, so it's approximately 2%. So my dazzling apple cheese salad gives me 28%. Level bonus at level 16. If I level it up to level 17, it will give me approximately 30%. Now, for some strange reason, and I'm not 100% why yet, this increase is not exact. It's not 2% every time. Sometimes I see some odd numbers here and there, but it is very close to 2% increase every level. So, taking everything we learned from this video, let's do one more example. This is an older video that I did. At the time, I didn't understand how dish strength worked yet, but now I do, so I'm gonna go back and see if it works. So I'm going to cook here now heat wave tofu salad. And we know that heat wave tofu salad has a base strength of 1976. And we know that at level 10, there will be an 18% bonus, which is already included in this number here. So we just got to remember 2332 and see how many extra ingredients I added in this video. So let's take a look. So I ended up adding an extra 9 sausages, 21 gingers, and 2 tomatoes. So we come along to this chart over here. We take the strength of each ingredient, so tomatoes, ginger, and sausages. So these were the numbers for sausages, 103, for tomatoes. No, that was for ginger. We put in 21 gingers. It's 109 per ginger, and then 110 per tomatoes. Add it together gives me this number, and plus the dish strength itself. And we come to this number, and we check the cooking. And you can see the level bonus up at the top there is 18%. And we finally got the exact number. Now, this was at Taupe Hollow. This video was recorded in Taupe Hollow, which was my first time there. So the area bonus is just nothing. There's no area bonus. But if there was an area bonus, I would multiply that at this point. And that is it for today. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If this video helped you, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Our Discord has all the information you need to tackle this game, and if it doesn't, you let me know and we'll add it in. I'll leave a link in the description below for you to join our Discord, and I'll see you in the next video.